everyone, and welcome back to Bedtime Stories. I'm teacher Emily, and I'm the librarian here at Antique. And today, we're going to be reading a very interesting book called Rosie Revere Engineer. This book was written by Andrea Beattie, so she's the one who wrote the words, and then illustrated by David Roberts, so he's the one who drew the pictures. So you can see we have Miss Rosie Revere here. And she seems to be making a lot of things. So let's see what she's been making. This is the story of Rosie Revere, who dreamed of becoming a great engineer. In Leela Greer's classroom at Blue River Creek, young Rosie sat shyly, not daring to speak. But when no one saw her, she peeked in the trash for treasures to add to her engineer's stash. And late at night, Rosie rolled up her sleeves and built in her hideaway under the eaves. So she's looking for garbage to create something, because she's an engineer. Alone in her attic, the moon high above, dear Rosie made gadgets and gizmos she loved. And when she grew sleepy, she hid her machines far under the bed where they'd never be seen. Look at her machines! Wow! I wonder why she's hiding them. When Rosie was young, she had not been so shy. She worked with her hair swooping over one eye, and made fine inventions for uncles and aunts, a hot dog dispenser, and helium pants. The uncle she loved most was Zookeeper Fred. She made him a hat to keep snakes off his head. From parts of a fan and some cheddar cheese spray, which everyone knows keeps the pythons away. And when it was finished, young Rosie was proud, but Fred slapped his knee and he chuckled out loud. He laughed till he wheezed, and his eyes filled with tears, all to the horror of Rosie Revere, who stood there embarrassed, perplexed, and dismayed. She looked at the cheese hat and then looked away. "I love it," Fred hooted. "Oh, I truly do." But Rosie Revere knew that could not be true. She stuck the cheese hat on the back of her shelf, and after that day, kept her dreams to herself. So she was really sad because her uncle, Zookeeper Fred, he was laughing at her invention. And that's how it went until one autumn day, her oldest relation showed up for a stay. Her great-great-aunt Rose was a true dynamo who'd worked building airplanes a long time ago. She told Rosie tales of the things she had done and goals she had checked off her list one by one. She gave a sad smile and she looked to the sky. "The only thrill left on my list is to fly, but time never lingers as long as it seems. I'll chalk that one up to an old lady's dreams." I wonder what Rosie's gonna do. That night, as Rosie lay wide-eyed in bed, a daring idea crept into her head. Could she build a gizmo to help her aunt fly? She looked at the cheese hat and said, "No, not I." But questions are tricky, and some hold on tight, and this one kept Rosie awake through the night. So when dawn approached and red streaks lit the sky, young Rosie knew just how to make her aunt fly. She worked and she worked till the day was half gone, then hauled her cheese copter out onto the lawn to give her invention a test just to see the ridiculous flop it might turn out to be. So she's trying this invention even though she is not sure if it's going to work. I wonder if it's going to work. Strapped into the cockpit, she flipped on the switch. The Hello Cheese copter sputtered and twitched. It floated a moment and whirled round and round, then froze for a heartbeat and crashed to the ground. Then Rosie heard laughter and turned round to see the old woman laughing and slapping her knee. She laughed till she wheezed and her eyes filled with tears, all to the horror of Rosie Bouvier, who thought, no, never, not ever again, while I tried to build something to sputter or spin, or build with a lever, a switch, or a gear, and never will I be a great engineer. So she's really sad again because her invention didn't work. She turned round to leave, but then great-great-aunt Rose grabbed a hold of young Rosie and pulled her in close and hugged her and kissed her and started to cry. You did it! Hooray! It's the perfect first try! This great flop is over. It's time for the next. Young Rosie was baffled, embarrassed, perplexed. I failed, said dear Rosie. It's just made of trash. Didn't you see it? The cheese copter crashed. Yes, said her great-aunt. It crashed, that is true. But first, it did just what it needed to do. Before it crashed, Rosie. Before that, it flew. So she's telling Rosie it's okay if you fail the first time. Your brilliant first flop was a raging success. Come on, let's get busy, and on to the next. She handed a notebook to Rosie Revere, who smiled at her aunt as it all became clear. Life might have its failures, but this was not it. The only true failure can come if you quit. That's a great lesson. That sometimes things just don't work out the first time. We have to keep trying. They worked till the sun sneaked away to its bed. Aunt Rose tied her headscarf around Rosie's head and sent her to sleep with a smile ear to ear to dream the bold dreams of a great engineer. So she's trying again. At Blue River Creek, all the kids in grade 2 build gizmos and gadgets and doohickeys, too. With each perfect failure, they all stand and cheer, but none quite as proudly as Rosie Revere. The end. Awesome. I really love that book. I think it has a great message that we should always keep trying, even if something doesn't work out the first time. Thank you guys for listening. I'll see you next time. Bye.